everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this video. So the people who have their examinations right around the corner should have started their preparations very hard. So this video is going to help all those people only. So let me tell you that the questions that I'm going to discuss are particularly important for your RBI, SEBI and NABARD examinations for the phase one, guys. So let's begin today's video on that note. But before that, if you have not subscribed to our channel till now, then do subscribe and hit the bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where you will get free PDFs as well as, not free PDFs, you will get the free quizzes on this channel as well as you can get your queries resolved on this channel. Okay, so now let's begin with the very first question of the day, which is about the central government special package for livestock development. A very, very important question if you are preparing for NABARD examination. So the people who don't know, let me tell you that NABARD grade A and B notification is out. So notification has been provided by the NABARD, but the official notification PDF is yet to be released. So if you are planning to give the examination this year, then study hard, guys. And this is one of the questions that can come in your upcoming examination. So now let's begin with this question. So what is the outlay of this central government's special package for livestock development? So you have different amounts. The right amount is 9,800 crores. So guys, by investing this much amount in the livestock development, the central government aims to raise the investment of rupees 55,000 crores into the livestock sector. I hope that you're understanding my point. By investing this much amount, the government is aiming to attract an investment of this much amount in this livestock sector. Now remember that this amount is being invested by the central government, whereas this investment will be the outside investment. For example, the state governments, the cooperatives, FPOs. So these kinds of stakeholders can invest in this livestock development. So that is the target. By investing in this livestock development, the government is aiming to increase the total investment in this sector and attract more and more stakeholders towards this sector in order to benefit around 10 crores farmers or the people who are engaged in the livestock development or in animal husbandry in general. Now let us discuss what this package entails for the farmers and for the NABARD students particularly in detail. Guys, I'm continuously saying NABARD student, but that does not mean that RBI or SEBI students can ignore this question, because this question can come up in those examinations as well. So do listen to me very carefully. Okay, so first of all, the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved this package. This point we have already discussed at length. The next point here is that this entire package aims to make the animal husbandry sector more remunerative for the 10 crore farmers engaged in it. Basically, under this package, all these schemes of the Department of Animal Husbandry and Dairy will be merged into three broad categories. So this is the cynosure of this entire package, guys. So under this package, what is being done, entire entire corpus of the schemes or entire schemes of this Department of Animal Husbandry and Dairy will be merged into three broad categories. So what are these three broad categories? First category is to develop the indigenous livestock. Okay, second is to protect that livestock from diseases, so disease control. And third is to increase the or develop the infrastructure for those livestock. So these are the three broad categories. Now we are going to understand all these three categories in detail. So here we have the three categories. I hope that everything is visible to you. So the first component here is the development program, wherein indigenous cows and dairy development will be focused. Now, what are these schemes, or what is the name of the schemes that are going to be merged under this component? So the schemes are Rashtriya Gokul Mission, which focuses on the development of indigenous breeds, as well as National Program for Dairy Development, National Livestock Mission, Livestock Census, Integrated Sample Survey. So these are the five programs. These are the five different initiatives taken by the Department of Animal Husbandry and Dairy for the development of cows. And those schemes are being merged into this first component. The next component is disease program, disease control program, basically. So here, the health of the livestock, livestock will be taken care of. So it includes health and disease control scheme as well as national animal disease control program. Next comes the infrastructure development program. It will merge the animal husbandry infrastructure development fund, dairy infrastructure development fund, and also support the dairy cooperatives and FPUs. Now guys, this animal husbandry infrastructure fund, if you remember, it was launched last year only as part of the Atmanirbhar Bharat package. So what is the total outlay of this fund? As I have told you that whenever it is a fund released or launched by the central government, outlays are always important. So what is the total outlay of this fund? It is 15,000 crores. And what is the outlay of this dairy infrastructure development fund? It is rupees 8,000 crores. Guys, it's not exactly rupees 8,000 crores. There is some 8 point something, but that is not very important for us to remember. You can remember it in complete round figures. It's rupees 8,000 over rupees 8,000. Now, remember that this fund is parked with NABARD. So NABARD is the karta dharta of this fund. So it is taking responsibility of this fund and it is implementing the projects under this fund. Okay, so therefore this also becomes important. Now, when was this fund launched? I told you this was launched in 2020, this was launched in 2018. So basically it was announced in the union budget of 2017 to 18. Remember that as well. Now let's move on to the next part of this scheme only, but before that I would like to tell you guys that all these missions, like Rashtriya Gokul Mission, this National Animal Disease Control Program, so these are very old programs. So they have been launched decades back, as well as some of them have been launched 5 years, 4 years, 2 years back. And all these programs have been extensively covered in our government schemes bundle, as well as in our government schemes videos. Therefore, I'm not taking up all these schemes again here, but it is your responsibility to cover all these schemes in detail for your examination, because question can come up on any of these schemes, okay? Now, this is the last part of the scheme and this was the additional announcement made by the cabinet, wherein it was announced that under this particular national program for dairy development, 8,900 bulk milk coolers will be installed and 20 LLPD milk capacity will be procured. So this much of milk will be procured. And under this NPDD only, the financial assistance is taken from this Japan International Cooperation Agency. Guys, I have told you about two important funds, Dairy Development Fund as well as Animal Husbandry Fund. There is another fund that is very important and that has been launched by the government only for promoting the startups. That is Startup Seed Fund. Can you guys tell me the corpus of this fund, total corpus, in the comment section below? Moving on to the next question, very interesting question it is. Where is India's first grain ATM located? Faridabad, Noida, Indore, Gurugram, Chandigarh are in the options. Right answer is Gurugram. So Haryana government has launched this India's first grain ATM at the Farukh Nagar. In Gurugram, and remember it is a pilot project. If this becomes successful, then at other places also Haryana government will launch such kinds of ATMs. Now what does this mean? The grain ATM, does it mean that you have to deposit money and then you will get grain in return? No. This basically is the public distribution system in order to remove the hassle or the problems faced by the beneficiaries of the public distribution systems. This ATM has been launched. So basically this is going to provide you grains if you show it your Aadhaar card or your ration card. Okay? One of these you can show to the ATM and then it will give you grains. So why has it been launched? The first reason is to provide the grains effectively to the beneficiaries so that they don't have to wait for long hours in the long queues before the shops of these PDS. Okay? Second is to bring the transparency. How many beneficiaries have got the right quantities that they were entitled to? people can still lie, but machines cannot. Therefore, this ATM is going to help in bringing the transparency in the public distribution system, as well as it is going to become easy for the beneficiaries as well, because they are going to get the ration in the right quantities in the first place, and secondly, in a cost-effective manner. Okay. Now, the second point here is that this ATM is at present distributing only three crops, three grains, wheat, rice, and millets. Okay. So these ATMs are so much effective that they can disburse 70 kgs of the grain in just 5 to 7 minutes. And if you were to go to a PDS shop and get the 70 kgs of grain, it is going to take you around 1 to 2 hours in just collecting that grain only. Now that hassle has been removed by establishing this India's first grain ATM. Now, what is the full form of this ATM? The full form is Automated Multi-Commodity Grain Distribution Distributing Machine. So this is the full form of this first ATM. इसमें T तो कहीं आया नहीं, तो multi का T ही समझ लो. But this is the full form. Okay. So that was all about this first grain ATM. But grain ATM related to agriculture. So agriculture वाले लोग तो इसको बिल्कुल कान खड़े करके सुना है. I hope and you all have to remember it. Because again I'm saying, RBA and SEBI student cannot ignore any of the question that I have taught you till now and all the questions that I'm going to teach you in the course of this video. So don't ignore any question, guys, because all of these questions are important for your RBA and SEBI examinations as well to a large extent. Okay. Next question is, which of the following state or the union territory has recently launched the Horticulture Week? Jammu, Kashmir, Ladakh, Delhi, Punjab, Puducherry. Out of which Jammu Kashmir is the right answer. Who is the LG of this Union Territory? Tell me in the comment section below. So he has launched this Horticulture Week. Now what is the purpose? During the entire week, obviously saplings will be planted, and the Union Territory has set a target of setting of planting 25 lakh high intensity crops. Plants basically, high intensity plants. Okay, during this week. So that is the first target under this Horticulture Week. Now basically what are they going to do under this week? During the week, they are going to promote the planting of these saplings. Also, they are going to create water sources. So water sources are also going to be created. Third is nursery development. And fourth is training of farmers. Fifth is encouraging the farmers for adopting machines. So mechanization of the farming activity during this week. So basically nursery development, so they are going to encourage and aware the farmers to how to develop their nurseries. They are also going to train the farmers in using the new technologies. So they are also going to introduce new machines in the farming arena. So this is the target of this Horticulture Week, which is going to realize the aim of doubling the farmers' income by 2022. So this is the central government's aim to double the farmers' income by the year 2022. Which committee gave this idea, or which committee gave the report on doubling the farmers' income? So the committee was Ashok Dalwai Committee. Remember this question, guys, because this question was asked from you in your previous examination. I guess NABARD examination or in RBI examination, there was a question on this only, that who recommended the, who gave the recommendation on doubling the farmers' income. So then Ashok Dalwai Committee was the right answer. Okay. So remember, it is Ashok Dalwai Committee which gave the recommendation on doubling the farmers' income by the year 2022. And in order to achieve this dream only, this Horticulture Week has been launched by the Jammu Kashmir administration. Who is the LG? This is your question that you are going to tell me in the comment section below. Moving on to the next question. आशा बोनालू इज द स्टेट फेस्टिवल ऑफ विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेट. स्टेट फेस्टिवल्स आर ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज दे कैन बी आस्क्ड फ्रॉम यू इन योर एग्जामिनेशन. तमिलनाडु, उत्तर प्रदेश, तेलंगाना, उड़ीसा एंड हरियाणा आर इन द ऑप्शंस. द राइट आंसर हियर इज तेलंगाना. सो बेसिकली द मेजर हब ऑफ दिस फेस्टिवल इज द ट्विन सिटी ऑफ तेलंगाना, दैट इज हैदराबाद एंड सिकंदराबाद. सो मेजोरिटी ऑफ द फेस्टिविटी इज सेंटर्ड ऑन दीज टू पॉइंट्स ओनली. Okay, so let me tell you that during this festival, the goddess Mahakali is worshipped and there is an offering called Bonam. So this is nothing but the prasad that we offer to the deities. But remember this name if you can remember it. So Bonam is the name of the offering that is made by the devotees to the goddess Mahakali. And it is this festival is celebrated in the month of June or July. So it is according to the Hindu calendar. So that was all about this question. One fact here is that this became the state festival when Telangana got its independence or Telangana got its statehood back in the year 2014. Okay, so next question is, with which country has India signed an MOU for cooperation on coking coal? Denmark, Australia, Japan, Gambia and Russia, out of which Russia is the right answer. So let me tell you that this coking coal is a very important raw material in making the steel. So this MOU is going to strengthen the steel industry in India. Okay. Now, do you know that India fulfills its demand of coking coal by imports only? So 85% of our demand is fulfilled with imports only. And the majority of these imports come from Australia. Basically, the 85% of this, the 85% import, or we can say the entire import, comes from Australia, South Africa, then Canada, and US. So these are the four countries from where we import a major chunk of coking coal. And remember that coking coal from all these four countries becomes very expensive because of the transportation and logistic cost, because they are very far from India. In comparison to Russia. Yeah. So the coking coal imports from Russia would be cheaper for India in comparison to the coking coal import that we make from Australia, South Africa, Canada and USA. So that is why this MOU has been done by both the countries. Now guys, the second thing that you need to remember is that the majority of coking coal, almost 50% of the coking coal, is imported from Australia. Okay. So the basic purpose of signing this MOU is to reduce our cost of producing steel as well as to diversify the sources of coking coal imports. So that is the main purpose for which this MOU has been signed. Now, recently Union Cabinet has also approved another MOU signed by India with Denmark. So that MOU is in the field of health and medicine. So basically, India and Denmark are going to collaborate so that they can indulge into research, so that they can bring technological innovations in the health and medical sector. So in order to bring the technological innovations in this sector, India and Denmark have signed an MOU which has been approved by the Union Cabinet. So that is another MOU which is in the news right now. The next question is, in which state, if Co-Kisan Sanchar Limited is going to set up 17 farmer produce organizations in collaboration with NABARD and NCDC. So Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Gujarat are in the options, out of which Gujarat is the right answer. So out of these 17 FPOs, 5 will be established by NABARD in four districts of Gujarat, whereas 12 FPOs will be established by this NCDC in 2 districts, 6 in each district. Okay, NCDC stands for National Cooperative Development Corporation. So this is the bifurcation. Now this is not at all important for you guys. The information that you can remember from this news is that 17 FPOs are going to be established in Gujarat by this IFCO Kisan Sanchar Limited with the help of NABARD and NCDC. Now, what is the target of the central government of establishing FPOs? So by the year 2025 to 2026, that is FY26, 10,000 FPOs are going to be established by the central government. So that is the target of the government. So remember the overall target, which is very important. 10,000 FPOs are going to be established. Now, if we talk about this IFFCO Kisan Sanchar Limited, so it is basically a joint venture of Bharati Airtel. And Star Global Resources Limited. And this IFFCO Kisan Sanchar Limited is basically Kisan Sanchar. Sanchar is to deliver the message, to disseminate the message. So basically this provides the telecom call center kinds of services to the farmers. Also it provides the services like information providing. So it provides information to the farmers in relation to livestock feed or in relation to different segments or different sectors which are relevant for the farmers. Okay, so that is the functioning of this Kisan Sanchar Limited. Okay, now your task is to tell me the chief of IFFCO. Who is the present chief of IFFCO in the comment section below. So that was all for today. I hope that you have learned something during the video, and if you have, then do not forget to subscribe our channel and share this video as much as you can among your friends, particularly those whose examination is right around the corner. Thank you so much for watching the video.